views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio. Light shines on Lyme disease. Lyme Light Radio with Katina Makris is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential to expand awareness and activate change to eliminate Lyme disease for good. Lyme Light Radio is a much-needed venue for the USA's number one fastest-spreading infectious illness. Katina is an award-winning author, a natural healthcare practitioner with over 30 years' experience, and most importantly, a healing force with her own personal Lyme journey. Be part of a movement to help end the suffering and confusion surrounding Lyme disease and begin to take action. Now here's your host, Katina Makris. Then I go.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Katina Makris, and welcome to Lyme Light Radio. I know all of you have been anticipating today's show. We have one of our all-time favorites back with us today, Dr. Richard Horowitz. He just has a half an hour with us today, and then we're going to do question and answers that I can take your calls. Write the number down right now, 800-930-2819. Dr. Horowitz had he'll fill us in. He had a really chock-filled day today. But for those of you who do not know Richard Horowitz, he is world-renowned as one of the most prominent Lyme disease specialists with an integrative medical center that combines both classical and complementary approaches in the treatment of Lyme disease and other tick-borne disorders up in the Hudson River Valley. And he has treated over 12,000 chronic Lyme cases in the past 28 years with patients coming from all over the world, Europe, Australia, New Zealand, Canada. He is one of the founding members and past presidents of the International Lyme and Associated Disease Society, and also the past president of the International Lyme and Associated Disease Educational Foundation, a nonprofit organization dedicated to education of healthcare professionals on tick-borne diseases. Dr. Horowitz presents worldwide on the topic of Lyme disease, and he has been awarded the Humanitarian of the Year Award by the Turn the Corner Foundation for his treatment of Lyme disease, and he has dedicated his life to helping those who are stricken with this devastating illness. His New York Times best-selling book, Why Can't I Get Better? Solving the Mystery of Lyme and Chronic Disease, was published with St. Martin's Press in 2013. So, Dr. Richard Horowitz, welcome back to Lyme Light Radio.
Thanks, Katina. It's a real pleasure.
Oh, my gosh. It's always a delight to have you on air with me. Let's immediately tell people where you were this morning.
Well, the reason I could only do a half hour is I got a phone call yesterday from the Today Show with Kathy Lee and Hoda, so I had to take a 5:40. I had to get up early this morning and take a car service down to New York City. I was on the Today Show at about 11 o'clock this morning.
Fantastic. I'm so proud of you. That's fantastic. I'm sorry I missed it, but I bet it was great.
Yeah, they'll probably be up on my Facebook page. We'll get the link eventually.
We'll get the link up. So we're a little bit later. Let's talk about Omega Institute, because you and I and Dr. France Scott are teaching there. Well, actually, let's talk about it right now. Omega Institute, right in beautiful Rhinebeck, New York, living well with Lyme disease. We've got a fabulous workshop coming up, don't we?
Yeah, I think it's going to be great for people. The one thing that I've done compared to last year, I mean, we had a great initial one last year. From what I understand, the registration has already quadrupled just about from where we were last year. And all of the scientific references since my book came out and since the last year, I've now incorporated into this new talk. So there's a lot of new scientific information that's going to be presented about persistence of Lyme disease, some of the newer tests that have come out, some of the newer co-infections that are showing up in ticks, I think people are going to find it fascinating because as I was going through all the literature, I've been saving these scientific articles on my desktop, and I started having to go through them to get them onto slides. I realized there's some really fascinating information on Lyme and tick-borne that is not just for people suffering from Lyme, but people with other diseases where they have overlapping factors such as environmental toxins, heavy metals, detox problems that are also affecting their health. So I think people are going to be really surprised as far as all the new science that's come out in the last year. It's very exciting.
I know. It's really so much is happening, and actually some new testing. I'm seeing some antigen testing coming and a couple of new nanotrap tests. There's a lot on the horizon right now, isn't there?
Yeah, I mean, we need new tests because the testing that's there right now, I mean, I'm sure most of your listeners know, but the testing is just not reliable. Mm-hmm. The ELISA test has a sensitivity of about a coin flip. You're going to miss half the cases. John Hopkins, when they did the initial studies on early Lyme, said it would miss 55%. Some of Ray Stricker's early work was it would miss 56%. And the New York State Department of Health, when they did studies with the CDC back in the late 80s, it missed 81% of the people who did not have bullseye rashes. So the testing is not great. When I met with Ben Beard from the CDC a couple of months ago with Dr. Liegner, we were talking about the C6 ELISA test. It's a little bit better, especially for people that may have European strains of mm-hmm. Borrelia. I've checked it out myself, and it will pick up some of the people with a negative ELISA, but still will not pick up everyone. So some of these new tests, the nanotrap and some of the earlier tests, the Spira test, where they're looking at inflammatory molecules called cytokines to pick up mm-hmm. early infection where it can be cured, there is some nice research going on. We're not there yet, but at least the research is taking place.
That's great. And you're all over the place teaching. My gosh. I mean, what can you tell us, Europe versus America versus Canada? Is it everywhere the way we think it is?
It is. It's really it's a worldwide problem. It's an epidemic proportion throughout the United States and Europe. It's one of the global pandemics. The World Health Organization and the National Science Foundation has declared Lyme one of the global pandemics that's taking place with, you know, things like dengue fever and other diseases that are happening. So we've got a real problem with this disease, especially because it's the great imitator. Mm-hmm. It's imitating chronic fatigue and fibromyalgia and autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, MS. And people are relying on the blood test when we don't have great blood tests. You have to understand really how to clinically diagnose it. Mm-hmm. And that was part of what I was talking about this morning on the Today Show, was that it's a clinical diagnosis. And, you know, for the people listening, one way of knowing if you have Lyme disease is if you've been ruled out for other diseases by your doctors. You've gone to a rheumatologist, you've gone to a neurologist, they can't figure out why you have headaches and memory and concentration problems and you're dizzy and you've got light and sound sensitivity and you've got migratory joint pain that's moving all over your body and you're tired. If they can't figure out these symptoms and, mm-hmm. and you've been diagnosed, for example, with an autoimmune or chronic fatigue fibro, the way to know is Lyme has a very specific clinical picture of coming and going, good and bad days. It's multisystemic. There are many symptoms, but the key is really the migratory nature of the joint pain, the muscle pain, or the neuropathy, the tingling, numbness, burning, where it just moves around your body, where one day it's in one joint and 2 days later it's someplace else. You don't see any other diseases that really presents that way. And women will tell you around their menstrual cycle that the symptoms get much worse with the hormonal changes. Mm-hmm. And if they happen to take antibiotics for an unrelated infection, a urinary tract infection or an upper respiratory, people will usually say that their underlying symptoms get better or get worse, which would be when you're killing off the Borrelia. So we can use these kind of classic symptoms of multifactorial, coming and going, good and bad days, migratory, changes with hormones, changes with antibiotics, and then you play Lyme bingo on top of that, which is you do a Western blot, even if the ELISA is negative, and if you get back any one of five bands on a Western blot through a good lab like Igenix that uses more than one strain, because there's 100 strains of Lyme in the United States and the commercial labs use one strain.
I know. Well,
that really doesn't make an awful lot of sense. But if you get any one of five numbers, I call them Lyme bingo, on the mm-hmm. Western blot, the 23, 31, 34, 39, 83/93, these are specific for Borrelia. And what's really important is there are other strains of Borrelia, like a relapsing fever Borrelia called Borrelia miyamotoi. They discovered that 4% of people in New England now have been exposed to this bug. It looks like Lyme. It smells like Lyme. It can cause bullseye rashes. It can cause a Bell's palsy. It can cause a meningitis. And yet you're not going to get a positive ELISA test. So the Borrelia-specific bands are important because it is part of the Borrelia species. You can kind of use this way of helping to diagnose some of these other Borrelia species.
This is so critical, Dr. Horowitz. I mean, how are we going to get our doctors educated?
Well, I've encouraged them to read my book.
Of course, they have to, right?
Yes, and some haven't. It's helpful, and I'm working at this point. I think you know about it, but I'm still working on an app. We're going forward. Mm-hmm. We're working on an app for phones and computers. There's a foundation we formed called the Lyme Navigator Foundation. It'll be the Lyme Navigator app where you just put in your symptoms into the app, and it will give you a differential diagnosis. You and your doctor can then work together to do the tests. Your doctor may give you a treatment, and then you put in the response to the treatment, and it'll keep running you through the 16-point MCIDS model that I discuss in my book so that you don't have to come and see me. You can work with your healthcare practitioner, or it'll be covered by insurance. So we're really hoping to get that out in the next couple of years. And we spoke with IBM Watson recently. They have an interest, actually, in looking at the model. So we're in discussions right now.
That's fantastic. That would be, you know, that's a game changer for people. I mean, they're not stuck in this old-fashioned model of this just very, very limited understanding. Most doctors are driving in the dark. I actually feel bad for them. With the training that they get in medical school. It's so very limited. This is cutting edge. Thank you, Dr. Horowitz, for working so hard for so many millions, really, who are suffering. It's phenomenal what you've been doing. So stay with me because we've got to take a quick station break and we're going to come back because I know we only have a limited time with you. So audience, stay tuned. This is Katina Makris with Lyme Light Radio with Dr. Horowitz today. We'll be right back.
Pure Encapsulations is committed to producing the most complete line of research-based nutritional supplements, from fish oil to probiotics to multivitamins and more. Available through qualified health professionals and community pharmacists, finished products are pure and hypoallergenic to optimize the long-term health of all patients, even the most sensitive. With Pure Encapsulations, you can rest assured that you're getting the purest and highest quality nutritional supplements available. Ask a qualified healthcare practitioner about Pure Encapsulations today and discover why it's the supplement brand of choice for healthcare professionals worldwide. For more information, please visit www.pureencapsulations.com. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. These products are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Artie Hoffman is the hottest psychic with the warmest heart and the host of the hit show Angels and Answers. A renowned psychic medium, spiritual life coach, and an entertaining motivational speaker, Artie has helped over 15,000 people with his amazing intuitive gifts, his passion, and his humor. Call 877-ANGEL-02 to schedule a personal reading or to have your own psychic Artie party. That's 877-ANGEL-02. And visit ArtieHoffman.com and Angels and Answers on Facebook. Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Limelight Radio with Katina Makris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimelightRadio.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Hi there, everyone. This is Katina Makris. Welcome back to Limelight Radio. We've got one of our favorite guests with us, Dr. Richard Horowitz, who is so renowned for his really breakthrough work with the Lyme disease epidemic. And Dr. Horowitz, one of my favorite topics, because it's so misunderstood by so many practitioners and patients alike, is the whole arena of the co-infections that the ticks carry. And these mycoplasmas and the Bartonella and how it can mimic, or actually mycoplasma can cause rheumatoid arthritis, or how they can trigger autoimmune disorders like lupus. Can you educate us on some of these organisms and what they do?
Sure. So the co-infections is really important because the ticks now are containing multiple co-infections. You can get one tick bite and several organisms can get it once. So usually they're divided up into bacteria. So you've got ehrlichiosis, you've got anaplasmosis, Rocky Mountain spotted fever. These are rickettsial infections, Q fever. There are these different Borrelia species like Borrelia miyamotoi, relapsing fever Borrelia that we were talking about. Mm-hmm. So those are some of the basic bacterial infections. With Bartonella, there's about 30 different strains of Bartonella. So that's why the testing doesn't always pick it up. They are finding mycoplasma in ticks, also a bacterial infection, which is inside the cell. Eva Schoppe did that at the University of New Haven. Mm-hmm. And then we're finding the parasites like Babesia. So this is like getting malaria on top of having Lyme. And one of the researchers in our area, Dr. Rick Osfeld from the Institute for Ecosystem Studies, found that in over 80% of the cases, when you get a tick bite, at least in our area, Babesia was being transmitted at the same point. If you get Babesia and Lyme at the same point, the Babesia causes malaria-type symptoms like day sweats, night sweats, which can be drenching. I just had a woman who came back from Cape Cod. I just saw her a little while ago. She had never had drenching night sweats, and she was there, and I suspected Babesia, and we put her on Babesia medicines while waiting for the test to come back. You will not get better if your symptoms are persistent with Lyme disease, and you're not sure why you aren't getting better, and you have day sweats, night sweats, chills, flushing. Some people will have an unexplained cough or air hunger where they can't catch their breath. Those are all classical symptoms of Babesia, and unfortunately, just like Lyme has 100 different strains, there's 100 different strains of Babesia. So that's why we're not always picking it up, but your doctor should be checking for at least two strains called Babesia microti and Babesia duncani Y1. And if you treat the Babesia, many of these chronically ill people will get better. But similarly, you were discussing Bartonella and mycoplasma. We do see quite a few infections with these. They're both intracellular infections. They're inside the cells. Very difficult to get rid of. They can be persistent. Mm-hmm. I just had a pregnant woman give birth to twins, and we treated her for Lyme throughout her pregnancy with Category B drugs that are safe, like Ceftin and Zithromax, and the amniotic fluid was positive for mycoplasma after 9 months of treatment with Zithromax, which should have normally covered it.
Wow.
And we see these type of persistent infections. I've seen the same thing with Bartonella. So if you have unusual stretch marks, some people think, oh, I've gained too much weight, but they're usually perpendicular to the skin. They can look like stretch marks, but a lot of times they're perpendicular.
Yeah.
That could be an indication of Bartonella. And mycoplasma, we find, as you said, in a lot of people with autoimmune overlaps, they've discovered in the rheumatological literature that mycoplasma can cause and drive autoimmune reactions. So these co-infections are responsible for a big part of why these people are staying sick. So when, you know, some of the doctors say, we don't know why you're still ill, one of the first places you'll always look, apart from persistent Lyme disease, is you need to look at co-infections. The other thing that's important in these patients is viral infections. Now, we don't see, fortunately, a lot of these viruses, but there are spreading viral infections that are now in the ticks. Mm-hmm. One of the more dangerous ones is called the Powassan virus. And most people think that, you know, oh, I don't really have to worry about taking a tick off within, you know, 18 to 24 hours, I'll be fine. But the Powassan virus, which can be deadly up to 10 to 15%, and in some case studies, 30 to 60%, it gets in within 15 minutes of a tick bite.
Wow.
And this can cause what's called an encephalitis, brain swelling,
yep,
where people can have the equivalent of having seizures, strokes, bad neurological symptoms, and it can be fatal. And it can get in a very, very short time. So prevention is extremely important. I was discussing this morning on the Today Show that you've got to have permethrin-treated clothing when you're going outside. You take your clothes outside, spray them. It's good for 1 or 2 weeks to repel the ticks. If you're in a really highly endemic area, you can use D 20% or higher, but you have to be careful because of the neurotoxic effects, especially in young children. And there are some natural tick sprays with eucalyptus oils that may also show some efficacy. But you should always carry a tick removal device, a fine point tweezers, or one of these devices that gets under the skin to remove the tick, and always constantly check yourself because these viral infections like Powassan, they can be very, very severe. And now they're finding the Heartland virus, the Bourbon virus, There's a new virus they just discovered in Florida in the last couple of months. I'll be discussing this at Omega, called the Tacarib virus, which can cause like a hemorrhagic type syndrome. That's now showing up in the Lone Star ticks, which is in Florida. So we're discovering year after year more and more of these infections. The Babesia rates, when I first moved up to the Hudson Valley, I was the first doctor to discover it, was about 3 to 4% of the ticks. Now it's over 40%. They found in Vermont that the rates of anaplasma doubled in the last couple of years. The Powassan virus has gone from 1 to 2% to 5 to 6% in the ticks in the Hudson Valley, and it spread to Connecticut and in other places. So we're in big trouble. These ticks are spreading. They're spreading across the U.S. They're containing parasites, viruses, bacteria. People need to know that these co-infections are serious and could be responsible for some of the illness. But the other thing that I find is really important, and this is what's explained in my book in detail, is I found up to 16 reasons why people stay ill. And I call this model MSIDS, Multiple Systemic Infectious Disease Syndrome. And it's like going into a doctor's office with 16 nails in your foot saying you have foot pain, and the doctor maybe finds one or two nails, but you go back saying you still have pain. The doctor didn't discover all the reasons why you still are sick. Those reasons go from everything from inflammation, autoimmune disorders, because Lyme can mimic lupus and rheumatoid. It can cause an autoimmune problem in the body. Lyme will affect your blood pressure. It'll cause something called POTS, dysautonomia, where your blood pressure goes very low. And some of your dizziness and memory problems may not be from that you need more antibiotics, but that your blood pressure is too low. Or you may be eating the wrong foods. You could have food sensitivities and allergies causing inflammation. Or the Lyme may have affected the hormones. You may be a man with low testosterone, or a woman with low estrogen, or low adrenal function, low thyroid function. All of these different things can take place in people, and a lot of times the doctors are only looking to treat with 30 days of antibiotics without realizing that there are these multiple overlapping factors that are causing people to be sick. And when I've, you know, treated these 12,000-plus people over 30 years now, roughly, we find that over 90% of the people who are chronically ill, we can identify multiple points on the 16-point MSIDS map that will tell them why they're still ill. And it's very important for people to know there is a map out there. If you're chronically ill and you haven't gotten better, you need to look at all of the factors on MSIDS. That's really what I found has made the biggest difference in people's health.
Oh, my gosh. Your MSIDS map is... it's so solid. It's very pragmatic. I often think of our body as like an ecosystem, like a terrarium, like our skin being the most external, and then these systems inside that work together in such miraculous fashion. And as you said, all of these issues like heavy metals or exposure to certain toxins or molds, I mean, they throw the whole ecosystem off.
Right. Yeah, we're now finding up to 2/3 of our patients who are not getting better are showing up positive for mold toxins. There's a test that's done in Texas. It's a urine test. And we're finding all these different mold toxins, aflatoxins, trichothecines, showing up in people, and they're dangerous. They're carcinogenic. They make people sick. They've been showing up in people with chronic fatigue syndrome. So these environmental toxins are definitely playing a big role, especially because some of them, like mercury, cause every symptom you see with Lyme disease. It causes fatigue, it causes memory problems, it causes nerve pain, it can cause psychiatric problems. So it's also a great imitator, and most doctors are never checking for some of these environmental toxins. So I believe, you know, looking at the Alzheimer's epidemic, and this is going to be fascinating for Omega, I think you're going to, you'll fall off your seat when you see the slides. I started accumulating scientific references over the last years, last 2 years, on Alzheimer's, and what is showing up in the literature of what's related. And you'll see that there are these multiple factors on the MSIDS map, up to 8 of them, that have now been proven in the scientific literature to have some association with Alzheimer's. And the problem is doctors are taught in medical school that there's one cause for one disease. But what if diseases like Alzheimer's is not just from one cause? What if it's from Lyme disease, which they're finding in the brains of Alzheimer's patients in the NIH data bank? But what if it's also from having periodontal diseases and you're getting spirochetes and Prevotella bacteria in your brains? Or what if the heavy metals like mercury and toxins are causing some of these amyloid plaques? Nobody has looked at this from a multifactorial perspective, and we've got an Alzheimer's epidemic, which is growing just like we have a Lyme epidemic. So we really need our best researchers and scientists to change the viewpoint and shift the paradigm from one cause, one disease, to looking at all of these different diseases and see which of the overlapping factors may be driving it.
Oh, yes. So true. So wisely said. And you're close to 30 years now of experience, really has really put you in such a position that I feel the graciousness in you, Dr. Horowitz. I mean, you are truly a pioneer and a fighter and an advocate for both the patient and the medical community making change, and the graciousness of how you handle so much. I really applaud you for that. You're really such a special human being. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And you're doing a great job too, Katina. I've been following you and watching what you're doing. I mean, you're on the path also, and I also greatly appreciate the way you're educating, and Lyme Light Radio is great. I mean, it's a great way to educate people to listen to the radio program and get experts on, so people can expand their knowledge. If you're in the middle of an epidemic, you have to have a source of regular education to be able to teach people the cutting-edge science of what's out there, because sometimes people won't hear about this stuff for years, and it really impacts their health.
It really impacts their health. So thank you. Thank you for making time for us today. I know you have patients waiting for you right now in your waiting room. So thank you so much. Get back to work. And I'll see you in a few weeks at Omega, everyone. eomega.com, June 26th to 28th, Living Well with Lyme Disease. Come here and learn from us. It's going to be a dynamite weekend. Thank you, Dr. Horowitz.
Sure. And if people have any other questions and want to learn about the MSIDS model, or if they question they may have Lyme, I have my questionnaire on my website, which is www.cangetbetter.com. So if you go on Can Get Better, there's a lot on there about a lot of the updated science on Lyme disease. My questionnaire is there that's been validated through SUNY New Paltz. And my Facebook is Facebook.com/Dr.Richard.Horowitz. Whenever the new science is coming out, I'm trying to put on Facebook the new articles and commenting. So if people want to track along, they can also do it through those sites.
Beautiful. That's excellent. Okay, everyone, stay with us. I'll be on air myself now answering your questions. So come back at the phone number 800-930-2819. I'll take your questions. Thank you, Dr. Horowitz. See you soon. This is Katina Makris with Lyme Light Radio.
Doctor Love's Quickies.
Mary's about ready to give love the shove, because no matter what she tries, guys don't know that she's alive. To turn guys on, she needs to turn on those green lights, nonverbal cues that say, over here. Most guys won't approach unless they're cleared for landing. So ladies, to kickstart your love life, turn on those green lights and flash your pearly whites. I'm Dr. Jamie Turndorf of AskDrLove.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit thetruthisfunny.com.
Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Limelight Radio with Katina Makris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimeLightRadio.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Welcome back to Lyme Light Radio, everyone. This is Katina Makris, and wasn't that a fantastic visit with Dr. Horowitz? He is such a gem. Honest to God, I mean, here he is, middle of his work day. He's been on a national TV this morning, and he slips in a half an hour with us, and what a wealth of knowledge. I love that idea about the new app that he's coming out with that would help patients and doctors coalesce their symptoms and then get proper testing and treatments. He's a genius. So anyway, I've opened up the phone lines. Everyone, the phone number at the station at WBLQ, Transformation Talk Radio, my headquarters for Lyme Light Radio, is 800-930-2819. I'll say it again, 800-930-2819. So let's take this next half an hour together and let me field your questions. It's my privilege, and I have a caller right now on the line, Kath Mitchell from Binghamton, New York. Hi there.
Hi, Katina. How are you?
Oh, my gosh. It's so great to meet you in person. We're Facebook friends.
I know. This isn't really quite in person. I hope we actually get to meet in real person someday.
In real person. I know. We're on radio person right now. So you're up in Binghamton, and that's a big Lyme area, isn't it?
It sure is. It's getting worse and worse by the day. I have so many people calling me all the time asking me for advice, and I try to direct them to your book, number one.
Your radio show
and all the resources that I have on hand just to help people because they are just desperate for help.
I know. I mean, Binghamton's what we would call upstate New York, and you've got a lot of farmland up there and a lot of woodlands, don't you?
We do. We have tons of deer, lots of wildlife, lots of woods. People love to camp, hike, and they need to protect themselves and learn the signs of Lyme because the doctors around here are just misdiagnosing people left and right, and they're suffering.
Oh, my gosh. Do you have any Lyme-literate practitioners in your area?
Very few. We do have to travel to the Hudson Valley, most of us, around here, or to Pennsylvania.
Oh, down to Pennsylvania. Right.
Most of them are two, three, or four hours away. Yeah, it's a
difficult situation. Now, so do you have a question for me besides thank you for giving us a little bit of a glimpse into what's going on in your area? I mean, I know New York State is really in trouble. It's Hudson River Valley, as you said, really, it's got the greatest resources. But what about, do you have a question for me?
I do. First, I wanted to say I read your book, and it was such an incredible account of what you've been through, and it rang true with a lot of people that have read your book because they've been through the same things you have and in some form or another. And I just was wondering, what do you attribute your amazing recovery to after being so sick?
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, really, really very powerful question to ask me. Yes. Well, first of all, thank you for the compliment. I wrote Out of the Woods because I was decimated by the illness. For those who have not read it, I was in a wheelchair and bedbound for close to 3 years and lost everything besides my health and happiness. My spirit broke and I lost my income and my career and my marriage and my home. And talk about bottom of the barrel, huh? And it really had progressed quite far, undiagnosed for 5 years. It had made its way into my neurological system. So I had all of those symptoms that so many people experience with the foot drop and the palsy and the migraine headaches and the dementia and the brain fog and the chronic fatigue and collapsed mitochondria. And I think what made such a critical piece in my recovery is that I would not give up on treatments. And I did not use the antibiotic protocol, which is kind of shocking. We used the antimicrobial herbs, mostly the Cowden protocol, Dr. Cowden's herbs, the cimento and banderol and teasel root and Japanese knotweed. But I think to answer your question most specifically, it was this great clinical nutritionist I found who would be equivalent to a really good integrative medicine doc or a good naturopathic doctor. And what he did is he ran these specialty tests that looked at my various systems. Like we looked at my GI tract and the inflammation and the good and the bad bacteria there. And then we did other profiles like on my adrenal glands and my thyroid and my pituitary and profiles on my brain neurotransmitters like the dopamine and then we looked at my detox pathway. So he kind of examined like each of the systems of my body, and we got an analysis of like where all the depletions were, Kath, and where all of the damages were, because that's what the organisms are doing. You know what I mean? They're like gobbling up your all your good like vitamins and minerals and amino acids. So I was so depleted. And I mean, it took me 5 years of treatment, but I stuck at it. Like I wouldn't give up. And we just kept rebuilding me from the ground up. So we uploaded, you know, my immune function to work better. And we got my adrenal glands balanced again. And we found out, you know, what was wrong with my thyroid. And we used natural thyroid supplements. And then my neurotransmitters, that took a while, you know, the brain chemicals. But I just kept plugging away, and I think a lot of people maybe give up a little bit too early, or they don't maybe find that right practitioner. So I really encourage people to seek out a naturopath, which has the initials ND after their name, or a clinical nutritionist, which is a CCN, or an integrative medicine doctor, because I think rebuilding those damages is so important.
Correct. So you didn't use antibiotics at all?
That's my big plug for integrative medicine, and also I think mending the spirit. My spirit was so fragile, you know. I was so very fragile and tending to
that. What did you do to help that along?
I found a very gifted healer, Dr. Meredith Young Sauer. She's got a great school called stillpoint.org. And I encourage people to visit her. She's got weekly inspirational messages and beautiful meditations and visualizations that I really used faithfully to start reprogramming my thought patterns from the despair and the hopelessness to hope and promise. And that was a very fundamental a year and a half or two for me as I kind of reprogrammed my thinking patterns. So anyway,
I think that's
another
so important.
Phone call here, which is exciting, but thank you, Kath, for checking in with me.
You're welcome. Thank you so much for all you do for us.
Oh, you're so welcome. It's my privilege. I hope I make a difference. So thank you. And Brian, who do I have on the line with me now?
All righty, we're going to take Emily from Maine. Welcome to Lyme Light Radio, Emily. What's your question for Katina?
Okay, thanks for taking my call. I am a big fan of yours, Katina, as you know.
Emily.
Hi. Can you hear me?
I hear you.
There's a little delay on my end. Can you hear me well?
I've got you. Yeah, I hear you. Thank you so much.
Okay. Well, my question's kind of long. I do a lot of local advocacy work, helping people to learn about Lyme, and I've got my own sources that I go to, and your podcast, this program is one of my main sources of information. But if somebody's just tuning in and doesn't realize it, I was wondering if you could just tell a little bit more about how you started this program and some of the people you've interviewed, like what the scope is that you cover here.
Thank you.
Of like, can we go and listen to podcasts if we've missed them? And resources that we could look at if we're trying to be Lyme educators ourselves.
Right. Oh, that's great. thinking. I love your strategy there, Emily. Well, yes. Well, first of all, unfortunately, you've got to stay with me for a second because Brian's just giving me the heads up that it's time for our station break.
Okay.
So when we come back from station break, let me answer those questions for you. Because, yes,
All right, thank you.
An advocate and pushing this conversation is absolutely critical in our society right now. So hold on, Emily. Don't move from the line. Listeners, stay with us. We're going to be right back. This is Katina Makris with Lyme Light Radio.
My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true, so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
Holistic Medical Center is where you find it all. A healthy space with doctors who care, see, and listen to the whole you. Hi, this is Dr. Darvish. If you have not found an answer to your chronic symptoms, you will find answers here at Holistic Medical Center. Our doctors find the root cause of your symptoms and guide your body towards healing naturally. We transform lives from within. Visit drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit thetruthisfunny.com.
Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Lyme Light Radio with Katina Makris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimeLightRadio.com.
1230 WBLQ.
Hi there, everyone. It's Katina Makris, and welcome back to Lyme Light Radio. We have a caller on our line, Emily from Maine. She just asked me a great question. If you have just tuned into Lyme Light Radio now, or you actually have heard about Lyme Light Radio and don't know how to access it, and my 2 years of podcasts, let's tell you how you can get into the archive, which is where all these fabulous interviews are with Dr. Horowitz and Dr. Klinghardt and advocates and authors and research individuals. I've had such a beautiful opportunity. So it's so easy. LimeLightRadio.com. When you get to the website, you'll see archive link, and you just click on it, and then there's the whole archives of shows from the past 2 years. The other way to get there is two other ways. You can go to iTunes, actually, and put Lyme Light Radio in the search window, and it'll bring up all the past archive podcasts on iTunes if you want to listen on your phone. And also our network is called TransformationTalkRadio.com. You could go to TransformationTalkRadio.com and again in the search window put Lyme Light Radio and you could find our past shows. And we are also in syndication with the Dr. Pat Show out of Seattle, Washington, which is really leverages our audience into the multi-millions. So such a great opportunity, Lyme Light Radio. So the easiest is just go to limelightradio.com and hit the archive link, Emily. That's what I would recommend. And often what I try to do is put up links to like today's show. We'll put it up on Facebook tomorrow. So you can always visit my page, Katina Makris, and see if the link's up, usually the day after. But yes, the second part of your question is if you want to start some advocacy work in your community, what do I recommend? And it's hard sometimes to put together a support group because then it puts you in a caretaker role and then you feel like, oh my gosh, we've got to do a weekly meeting. And I mean, that's not a bad thing to do if you want to take it on. But another thing that you might I know you would be really suited for because I do know you and you're an author with your beautiful book In the Limelight, is just to host, you know, a one time or maybe a twice a season, like a spring and a summer Lyme disease forum or question and answers, and just host it in your own town and make flyers. I do that myself. I make flyers and I hang them up like in the grocery store and the health food store and yoga centers. And usually there's a good turnout of 20 to 30 people and you can host a question and answer about Lyme disease and give people an opportunity, you know, to express their concerns. And what I often do too is maybe get like a pest service company, or if you've got a naturopath or somebody else in your community that might want to be part of the evening, they, the pest company can talk about prevention and what you can do with your yards and different sprays. And, you know, but that's a nice way to bring awareness and advocacy to your community is to host a Lyme disease awareness night or an afternoon. So I know you could do that. And, the other thing is those fabulous films, Under Our Skin or Emergence, you can go to their website and host a screening in your community.
Right. Yeah, and Emergence is like part two of Under Our Skin, isn't it?
Exactly. Like, Emergence is part two. I think it came out 5 or 7 years later. Andy Abrams Wilson, great filmmaker, and he follows the journey of 5 or 6 different people with their Lyme experience. So yes, you can go to underourskin.com and there's a link there of how you can request to view a film in, you know, in your community at a, like at a church or a civic center or whatever you've got in your community. So,
right. That's great when people can do that.
Yeah. And go ahead.
A resource that I just used today when I was doing a TikTok to some camp counselors was I found out that the Lyme Disease Association gives free brochures for the cost of the shipping. And anybody can go there and get free brochures to pass out to their community. I also gave them to the local daycare center because kids were coming in with ticks and parents needed to know more of what was going on. So.
Oh, that's great, Emily. Good for you. Thank you. Emily, I've got another caller on the line, so I'm going to take their question, if that's okay with you. Thank you. Thank you for joining me today, and hello to beautiful Maine.
Oh, she's already hung up.
Oh, who do we have, Brian? Who's with us?
We have Teresa from the Rose City of Oregon. Welcome to Limelight Radio. What's your question for Katina?
Hi there, Katina. Thank you for having me on your show.
Oh, my gosh, Teresa. One of my soul sisters out in Oregon. It's great to hear from you.
Yeah. Well, we are so excited to have you come and visit with us on your Oregon tour. But I had a quick question. One of the things when you're on your tour, we're going to be discussing your new book, and I'm wondering if maybe you could tell me a little more about it. People are asking lots of questions.
Oh, my gosh. Yes, thank you. That's a great idea. And, yes, thank you, first off, for for helping create a beautiful trip in Oregon, everybody. I'm going to be out multiple cities, Medford, Bend, Hood River, Portland. We've got a scheduled Lyme disease tour. I think, what is it, like September maybe 19th to 25th in that range, Teresa, isn't that correct?
Correct.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
Yeah, that's correct. So, I think you're coming out on the 16th and you'll be here to the 23rd. I think we've got two teaching seminars where you'll be working with our medical professionals, and then four or five other speaking seminars.
Oh, my gosh. I know. It's going to be jam-packed. It's going to be great, but I'm going to meet your support groups, and I'm so proud of your state for holding these support groups together, because Oregon is severely stricken, and you have not had much help at all. So I'm very honored to have been invited to come. So thank you. And my new book, the new book is Autoimmune Illness and Lyme Disease Recovery Guide, Mending Body, Mind, and Spirit. And this basically is a very important topic, because I'm showing, just the way Dr. Horowitz mentioned earlier in the program, how so many hundreds of thousands of people are being diagnosed with autoimmune conditions like lupus and MS and fibromyalgia, chronic fatigue syndrome. I was diagnosed with those two. And actually, it was the Lyme disease infection underneath that triggered the autoimmune response in my system, and it does in so many people. And then we end up on all kinds of drugs that aren't curative, but are just merely, you know, palliative. And so this book basically is, it's got a questionnaire, it's got diagnostics, it's got a huge section in what predisposes so many of us to even falling prey to the organisms, multiplying in our body and creating all the inflammation and all of these, you know, disease symptoms that we manifest. So that's the natural healthcare provider in me, 30 years of experience as a homeopath and intuitive healer. I've got a wealth of knowledge. So the book is multiple lenses. It's a look into what has gone sort of maybe tipsy-turvy in our environment and in our society and in our healthcare system, so that we are ending up with these kind of conditions. And then the second part is, you know, as I said, the crossover from autoimmune and Lyme and tick-borne, you know, Bartonella, mycoplasma. And then the third part, my favorite, is what can you do for your very own self? Like, how can you help yourself mend? And I bring in all kinds of things, from detoxification to self-help work with homeopathy to activating our mind-body healing pathway, which is an enormous reservoir of healing energy. So it's really a comprehensive book, and I hope the readers love it, because I put my heart into it.
Well, it sounds really exciting and amazing, and like I said, we can't wait to see you and are looking forward to a wonderful tour in Oregon.
Oh, thank you, Teresa. Thank you for coming on air with me today, too, and asking that question. And my book is available on pre-order right now at Amazon, but I will have it with me out in Oregon. It comes in print August 4th, so I'll have both Out of the Woods and the Autoimmune and Lyme Disease Recovery Guide with me. So it'll be my pleasure to share it with all of your beautiful citizens out in beautiful Oregon, such a pretty state. Thank you, Teresa. And Brian, I understand I have another caller I can't take. Apologies to whoever you are. Call in on our next show and we'll take your questions then. But everyone, I hope you enjoyed Limelight Radio today. Dr. Horowitz was fantastic. And thanks for calling in with your questions. My audience, you mean so much to me. It's been such a privilege to reach out across the globe and help bring education on this exploding epidemic to a global audience. Thanks, Brian, for your on your toes. Tune in next week, everyone. This is Katina Makris with Limelight Radio.
You've been listening to Limelight Radio with Katina Makris. Tune in each Wednesday at 1 Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Get ready for some of the most provocative conversation with leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. If you've missed any part of this hit radio show, visit limelightradio.com. That's limelightradio.com. We'll see you next week on Limelight Radio with Katina Makris. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me please.